the previous video, you learned how does DHCP work. You learned how does DHCP lease an IP address and how does a client renew its IP address. In this video, I'm going to show you three different methods for installing your DHCP server. Let's start. Before you start installing DHCP server role on your server, make sure to check the IP address of your server and confirm that it has a static IP address. From the server manager, select local server and click on the IP address. This will open the network connection console. From there, right-click on your network adapter and go to the properties. In the open dialog box, double-click Internet Protocol V4 and check your IP address. In order to install DHCP server on a server 2022 with graphical user interface, open Server Manager and from Manage menu, select Add Roles and Features. On the Add Roles and Features wizard, click Next on the first page to start. On the next page, select Role-based or Feature-based installation and hit Next. On Server Selection page, select your server and then click Next. Next page is where you need to select the role that you need to install. Select DHCP server. System will open a pop-up page and will prompt you to install the remote server administration tools for this role. Make sure Include Management Tools checkmark is selected and click Add Features. On the wizard, click Next and browse through the checks and make sure all required features including administrative tools for DHCP are marked for installation. Then hit Next. On the next page, wizard will explain what you will need to do after the setup is complete. Click Next to continue. On the last page, wizard shows you a summary of the settings you have selected. Click Install to start the installation of the required roles and features for DHCP server. Depending on your server speed, the process might take a few minutes. Unlike many other roles and features, DHCP does not require restart. After the installation is finished, you will notice that system will give you the option to continue to the post-installation steps of the setup right from the wizard. You can click on Complete DHCP configuration. Also, you can see that there is a yellow triangle with exclamation mark appearing beside your Manage menu. That's the notification area. This means that there are some pending actions to complete the setup. Before completing the setup, let's check our DHCP console first. Go to the Tools menu and select DHCP. This will open the DHCP console. As you will notice, the service is installed, but it has a red arrow pointing down on both IPv6 and IPv4 scopes. This means they are disabled and you cannot use this DHCP server. But why is that? If you install a DHCP on a standalone server, you will not need to complete this step and you can start configuring and using your DHCP. However, in a domain environment, DHCP servers are not allowed to serve. This is in fact a very important security setting. In the next few videos, you will learn that DHCP not only can provide IP addresses, but also it can provide other options to the clients as well. Options like gateways, DNS servers, and many more. Now, imagine a situation that in an organization, a hacker could install a DHCP server on a virtual machine on his or her own computer and then start providing IP addresses to the clients. Clients would not notice the change, they receive the IP address and continue to work. But the hacker could change the path of their traffic and forward them to its own systems. To prevent this in a domain environment, DHCP servers should be authorized to lease IP addresses. The process of authorizing a DHCP server is simple and quick, but it requires specific permissions. You should be a member of Enterprise Administrators Group in order to authorize a DHCP server. By clicking on the Complete DHCP Configuration from the Notification Center, Windows will open another wizard. This wizard allows you to authorize your DHCP. On the description page, it tells you the required permissions if you would like to delegate this task. User who's authorizing the DHCP server should be a member of Enterprise Administrators AD Group. Click Next to start the process. On the authorization page, select the user that you will use for this task. By default, wizard will select the credentials of the existing logged in user. If your user does not have the required permissions, you can select another user by selecting Use Alternate Credentials. Once you selected your user, click Commit to authorize your DHCP. Check the results in the summary page and click Close. Congratulations, your DHCP server is ready to be configured and used. Let's start installing the DHCP server with PowerShell. First, confirm your server is set with a static IP. From the server manager, select local server and click on the IP address. This will open the network connection console. From there, right-click on your network adapter and go to the properties. In the open dialog box, double-click Internet Protocol V4 and check your IP address. Now let's check if the DHCP is already installed. From the start menu, right-click on PowerShell and run as administrator. Type in Get-WindowsFeature *DHCP*. This command will list any features that has the word DHCP in it. As you can see, DHCP and DHCP server tools are available but not installed. In order to install DHCP server role and its administrative tools, type in install-WindowsFeature. With the previous command, we're asking Windows to list the features, and right now we're using install to initiate the installation. Type in install-WindowsFeature DHCP-IncludeManagementTools and hit enter. This will start the process of adding the roles to the server, and depending on your server speed, the process might take a few minutes. Once the setup is finished, PowerShell shows a summary that installation was successful and no restart is needed. You can check the installation by running the same command. Just type in get-windowsfeature *DHCP*. As you can see, the DHCP service and the roles are installed. To check the interface, you can refresh the server manager console and you will notice that DHCP would be added. As a last step, if your DHCP is in a domain environment, you will need to authorize the DHCP to allow it to operate. In the same PowerShell window, type in add-DhcpServerInDC DnsNAme, then make sure to put your server's name, the domain name of your server in quotes, -IP address, and enter the IP address of your DHCP server. And finally, hit enter. This will authorize your DHCP server. By opening the DHCP console, you now will notice that the role is installed and is ready to be used. To install DHCP server on a server core, you have several options. I will cover two of the most commonly used scenarios. You can either use Windows Core PowerShell, or you can log in to another computer with the graphical user interface and run the commands remotely. You can even use the consoles from the remote server to complete the installation. If you would like to use the Windows Core PowerShell, simply type in 15 at the sconfig window to exit the tool and enter PowerShell. Once you are in the PowerShell window, you can check for existing DHCP installation by typing get-windowsfeature *DHCP* and hitting enter. And if you decided to do the installation with the same PowerShell window, similarly, you can type in install-windowsfeature DHCP-IncludeManagementTools and hit enter. In this demo, I will install DHCP on a server core remotely from a server with graphical user interface. But in order to show you how does remote management works, I will be using PowerShell from another server with the graphical user interface. To install DHCP on a server core from another server, simply log into your server, open PowerShell as an administrator, and start configuring. If you run a command line similar to hostname, you will notice that the computer will return the results from the server that you are executing the commands from. In this case, it is returning the name of the server that I'm already logged in. If you check the DHCP installation on the existing server, you will notice that the service is already installed. This is the same server that we used on the previous step. Now let's connect to the server core and run the same commands against that server from this window. Connect to your server core by using Enter-PSSession commands. Type Enter-PSSession-computer name and your server name. Make sure that you put your server name in quotes. Hit enter. You will notice the prompt will change and show the name of your remote server at the beginning of the prompt. Type hostname and see the result. The PowerShell will return your server core's name. If you check the DHCP installation status, you will notice that the service is not installed. This is a simple test and a proof that although you are running PowerShell on your server with the interface, you are actually running the commands against your core server remotely. Now you can install the DHCP server by typing install-windowsfeature DHCP-IncludeManagementTools. Similar to previous installation, you can authorize the DHCP by either running add-DhcpInDC command line, or you can use a DHCP console from your server with GUI. For that, open the DHCP console and right-click on DHCP. From the menu, click Add Server. On the pop-up window, click Browse and search for your server core. Select your server and click OK. Wait a few moments, and you will notice the DHCP on your server core would be added to the same console. You can now right-click on the server and authorize. You can also use the same console for your day-to-day administrative tasks. Join me on the next video to learn how to configure your DHCP. You will learn how to create scopes, create reservations and exclusions, and how to configure DHCP options. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up and consider subscribing to the channel for more videos like this. Make sure to hit the bell icon to be notified when the new content is released. Also, leave a comment in the comment section down below and let me know what other subjects would you like to learn. Thank you for watching, and I hope to see you on the next video.